Okay, I'm just going to do a real quick video about this picture that was released by the White House today that was supposed to be showing Obama shooting a shotgun, supposedly Skeet shooting. So here's the original photograph as it appeared on Flickr, posted by the White House. What it says there. Okay, I took this picture and I just opened it up in Photoshop. And I'm going to point out some inconsistencies that I noticed with this photograph. Okay, let's expand this a little more. Okay, and it may be hard for you to see on my screen on video, but, you know, feel free to do this yourself. Yeah, the first thing I notice here, because I do a lot of photography, is that, of course, you have the woods in the background there are blurred because they're out of focus of the camera range. Okay, Obama himself looks very crystal clear. But if you look at the gun itself is somewhat out of focus. It's a fuzzy image. So which means that the gun was not photographed at exactly the same focusing range as the picture of Obama. Okay, another thing I would like to point out about this picture is, okay, you see here the smoke coming from the gun where he supposedly just fired it. Well, maybe that would explain, you would think, the gun being partially out of focus. I mean, shotguns have a kick, and you would think, well, okay, the gun kicked. That made the gun out of focus. Well, no, I don't know how many of you have ever shot a real gun, but if you shoot a real gun, it's going to kick, and then he himself, his body, would have jolted too from the kick of the gun, and he would not be in focus either. There would be a bit of a blur around him. And another thing, if he just fired this gun, as this smoke would have us believe, okay, why is his face and nose pressed so tightly against the butt of that gun? Anyone who has fired a real gun can tell you right now that is not what you want to do, especially on a shotgun. When that shotgun kicks back, it's going to hit you in the face. If your nose was pressed up against it like that, it could possibly break your nose. So I find this kind of hard to believe. If, in fact, he did just fire that gun, his face would not be so firmly planted on the butt of that gun. Another thing I would like to point out is this little detail right here. Okay, here you have the gun in Obama's hand. Okay. There's a problem here. Okay. Do you see the edge of this gun? Let's do this so I can demonstrate. The edge of the gun here. Okay. Let's get it right where it belongs. The edge of the gun would be here. Okay, what do you see overlaying in that one little portion right there? A piece of Obama's hand, which could not be there because that should be part of the gun. It appears that this photograph was photoshopped to be released to the public. Why? I don't know, to endear himself to gun owners, I suppose. But this is a mistake right here. I do a lot of Photoshop. You would erase that. So somebody made a mistake there. Whoops. Let's get rid of that. Okay. Whoops, come on. Picture move. The other little detail. Up here. In this area. Okay. This is supposed to be a piece of Obama's thumb. Okay. If you look at his hand. Okay. There's no way that his thumb is that long. Do you see how long his thumb would have to be? There's no way his thumb is that long. I'm saying that this gun image came from another image, and they photoshopped it into Obama's hand, and they forgot to, again, erase that. And if, in fact, Obama does have abnormally long thumbs, again, this right here is a gap where a piece of his thumb should be. And it's not there. So, oops. Why does it matter? You know, why does it matter? Why does anyone care? Oh, well, let me point out one other thing, too. Anyone who has ever shot skeet before knows that they are clay pigeons that are released by, like, a pitching machine. And they go up in the air. And normally you wouldn't be pointed at aiming at this angle. If you were, in fact, really shooting skeet, you would be... It would be more natural to be aimed more upwards, because that's where the skeet are thrown, up into the air. Unless, just by chance, you know, this photo was taken as the skeet was coming back, falling back to the ground. There's a lot of things about this picture that just don't add up. But you can make your own decision. And like I started to say before, you know, why does it matter? Why does anyone care if that's a Photoshop picture? You know, we know that the government lies about things. The point is, you really should care if your government lies to you and feels the need to Photoshop pictures and blame things on YouTube videos when, in fact, that is not the truth. I think, as American citizens, the least we could expect out of our government is the truth. But, like I said, open this photo up yourself, enlarge it, if you don't believe what I'm showing you here, see it with your own eyes. Okay, thanks everybody, see you later. Okay, I have one little quick addition to make to the video. When I watched my video back, what you just saw, when I replayed that, I noticed one other thing. The way Obama's face is placed on this gun, okay, whoever photoshopped this kind of overcompensated by showing it pressed so firmly into his face. I mean, let's face it, Obama is not overweight. And he has a very thin face. There's not that much jowl that would overlap onto a gun like that. Also, if you look really closely, and I'll show you, I have a post-it note here for a straight edge. If you, again, look at the edge of the gun where I'm placing the post-it note, his nose, his nostril, is actually overlapping onto the butt of that gun. Do you see? This is his nostril. That, so, unless he's got the gun, like, shoved up his nose, there's no way that is possible. Whoever photoshopped this didn't do a very good job. That should definitely not be overlapping there. So yeah, that's it. That's all.